I live in West Kirby, and I would never ever say anything against the fire brigade. They are a marvellous brigade, certainly around Merseyside. And I do get a situation where now and again they can get things wrong. Now, if you're talking about an expert, I'd probably say I'm an expert, because where they want to put that fire station, I travel past that 5, 6, 7 times a week. I come from West Kirby, I come from Hoyle, and I come from other areas. There is no possible way that on the blue light, they could, there's anywhere they can park to get the cars out of the way to get down Heron Road, Bunt Lane, and head over to it. Now, I'll say whether out the times, I'm not sure. I've asked the question numerous occasions. I've even asked if they've done a blue light block, that is, in emergency, down any of these side roads. I'm led to believe they have not. I'm also led to believe that when they're trying to calculate distances, it's different around the country. They may sit around and say, Merseyside can be so-and-so, another area can be so-and-so. It depends on the area itself. Now, I absolutely believe that there's no possibility that the time they are quoting that they can do at certain times. Maybe 90% of the time they can. I probably agree with them there. But there's probably 10% of the time they cannot. Now, the most important part is, as the senior officer said, is the first 2 minutes. Now, the first 2 minutes is get from A to B. If you get stuck behind a cyclist, the cyclist will get out of the way, that's fair enough. If there's cattle on the road, and I'm sorry, you won't get cattle in the middle of the city, but you've got cattle on the road around this area. You get tractors coming up and down. I think they got that wrong slightly. I also remember speaking to our transport department over something completely different 12, 18 months ago, when I was asking the possibility of heavy goods going down Heron Road. They didn't believe it was right that heavy goods could go down Heron Road, because I was asking for them to do something completely different to what's here today. I personally think that the time they are producing, they've got wrong. And I say I'm an expert because I do that road 10 times a week. I don't know how many fire officers do that, certainly the people who are actually telling us the times. Thank you, Chair.
Looking at page 53, on our fifth paragraph down, it talks in the report about predictive modelling was carried out to assess what the response times for the proposed fire station on Saughall Massie Road would have been. Now, I've asked the question about this because predictive modelling didn't mean too much to me. And like Councillor Boult has said, the hazard been tested on blue lights. I've had two responses to that, that they can't test on blue lights, and the reason for that being that it isn't illegal to do so, and if an accident was caused, then it would be covered under health, safety, etc. So that is one of the reasons why that hasn't taken place. The predictive modelling is a nationally recognised modelling which is used across the country. And the other point that I wanted to bring Keith in on, because we're talking about here, Councillor Bob talked about Heron Road being the access road and can be impassable at times, which we've read in the report. It does say that these agricultural vehicles will travel down that road. It says 350 cows may cross that road at any point in time. But can I just ask, Keith, can you clarify whether there are other access points, other roads that can be used if that situation should occur?
Thank you for your chair. I mean, there are other routes to get to towards Melt and Loy Lake in favour, as an alternative to Heron Road. and the one that springs to mind is West Kirby Road, Saughall Road, Hoyle Road, both Head Road, and that brings us to the end of Heaven Road, where it connected both Head Road and that junction road going towards the Mells Bridge at the railway station. I've had a look at the distances involved, and that's about 300 metres longer than if you went along Heaven Road. But at certain times of the day, I'm certainly unsure that that would be a faster route than going through Heaven Road, because the roads on that route are less winding for the majority of the time and wider. So I think for certain circumstances, that road would be faster than Heaven Road, although that's 300 metres shorter.
Thank you. Cathy?
First of all, I'd like to make a comment that Councillor Donaldson made about disrespecting fire officers. I'd just like to say that I was a serving fire officer in the County Fire Brigade in the 1980s in the control room on Green Watch, and I have every regard for fire officers. My ex-husband was a fire officer as well. So what I say, having served in the fire brigade, I probably have more experience in the fire service than anybody else on this committee, and I have actually done a fire engine on manoeuvres on a training session. The PDA that is often mentioned is the predetermined attendance set down by the Home Office, and I'm assuming that the response times that are from Upton to the area that it covers is within the PDA laid down by the fire service or the Home Office. What the report is saying is that there will be an increased response time to US Kirby by up to 2 minutes, a reduction of 2 minutes, and an increase if it's Saughall to Upton by possibly 1 minute. On the basis that those response times are within the PDA, then we have to look at the circumstances surrounding those two given areas. I would say that the Upton sighting of the fire station, given its locality with the M53, as Councillor Blakely has also alluded to the Arabark Hospital and to the Tower Block, and the fact that probably 75% of call-outs are from Upton as opposed to 25% to West Kirby, then you have to look overall statistically at, if you're going to look at lives saved, how many lives are saved in one response to another. If you're going to come down to that, which I obviously wouldn't want to, but if we're looking at special circumstances, and the special circumstances surrounding this application seems to hinge exclusively on response times. So you have to say, is there a special circumstance being shown that the response time reduced in one way but increased in another outweighs keeping the fire station at Upton? And I know the Grenfell Tower disaster has been mentioned, and I think in the light of that, I think on balance, it would seem that the presumption to keep the fire station at Upton is a more sensible one. So I'd just like to reiterate, I have every regard for the fire service, as I say, having served in the County Mayhem Fire Brigade 30
years ago.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Cathy. David?
Yeah, thank you, Chair. I think I'd like to take the attempt to take the heat out of the situation here and just remind everybody that we are a planning committee. We're here to act on behalf of the people of Wirral without fear or favour or without political input. So try and keep to that. I've been on this committee for 17 years now, and we've tried and largely succeeded in maintaining that activity. So let's just take the heat out of it, not get too emotional, and try and consider the facts, which are, the planning officers have confirmed that the application for the new fire station does not fall within any of the established criteria that permits development in the Green Belt. I could quote detailed if you wish, I've taken the trouble to bring them, but I won't bore you with it in such a long evening. Therefore, the proposal is considered as inappropriate development for which very special circumstances should be and must be set out. So that is really why we're here today. May I just reaffirm that we are here purely and simply to decide whether the very special circumstances exist that would justify the development of this proposed community fire station at this particular unique location in Saughall, Massie. This justification appears to be based on the perception, and I use the word advisedly, that response times to West Kirby, Hoylake and Mells will be reduced sufficiently to overturn Greenbelt policy that would otherwise define the development as inappropriate. The perceived reduction in response times relies entirely on the use of a number of narrow, winding, rural roads that often exhibit unavoidable congestion and obstruction regularly at various times of the day. These obstructions, as you've already been advised, include movements of cattle for milking, slow-moving agricultural vehicles towing large tractors and trailers, and congestion, which has not been mentioned yet, that occurs daily at peak times at the Western end of the highway. Were traffic egresses onto Birkenhead Road. As a resident of Mells for most of the past 60 years, I am only too well aware of the traffic problems on this section of road and of the ill-informed naivety, and I use that phrase advisedly, of those believing that it can always provide an unobstructed rapid route to a fire or any other emergency. When these obstructions occur, there is absolutely no room for fire appliances to pass the obstructions or move forward in the face of obstructions and traffic coming in the opposite direction. There is just no room to pass. Residents at the western end of Heron Road constantly complain about the escalating problem and have campaigned for years for this section of road to be widened and improved. And I'm sure our highways officer here tonight will endorse that as a matter of fact, not conjecture and not hearsay. In addition, moving the fire station from Upton to the proposed Saughall Massie site will inevitably increase the response times to Arrow Park Hospital, the M53 and the residents and businesses near Woodchurch, from where 75% of the emergencies arrive